Manitowoc County Sergeant Andy Colburn and Lieutenant Jim Lenk, they took the witness stand. They said the claim by the defense that they planted evidence over a lawsuit filed by Avery for his wrongful rape conviction was ridiculous.
An immediate.
Have you ever planted any evidence against Mr. Avery?
That's ridiculous. No, I have not. I have to say that this is the first time my integrity has ever been questioned.
Now, Stephen Avery's attorney, Dean Strang, didn't ask Colburn one question about planting evidence, specifically the blood vial. The state asked the court to tell the jury to disregard any references to it.
You heard all the questioning about the vial of blood in the clerk's office in jury selection. You heard the contamination in press releases. You heard the contamination in opening statements. Now, for the first time, when evidence should be placed into the record, or at least placed into this particular case, we hear nothing.
I'm idealistic. I'm certainly naive at times, but I am not so naive to think that someone who may have planted blood evidence, who may have been involved in planting a key, would come into this courtroom and simply because asked under oath, did you do it, say, oh yes, I did. We are not going to have a Perry Mason moment here.
All right, Rob, let's talk about that because, the vial of blood came up all the time. He didn't ask one officer in the center of that anything about it.
Well, I think, Ken Kratz is doing his job, but I have to agree with Dean Strang here. I mean, if anyone thinks that Lenk or Colburn are going to get on the stand and say that, yeah, we planted evidence mm-hmm. against Mr. Avery, that's ridiculous. Of course they're not going to say that. So in some ways, cross-examining on that, it may be a waste of time. And they did answer the question on direct. So at this point, it's way too premature. The defense still hasn't even gotten to their case, mm-hmm. and let the defense put on their evidence and then see what they come up with.
All right, but as we find out, the very next day on Wednesday, Lieutenant Link defended himself against allegations that he planted Avery's blood in Teresa Holbach's SUV. Avery's attorneys say Link, an evidence custodian for the department, knew the blood was there and could have planted it. Link said he found out the vial of blood was sitting in the clerk's office last December.
Did you ever plant it anywhere in Teresa Halbach's vehicle or anywhere where it could be found as part of this investigation?
No, sir, definitely not.
Lieutenant Link also testified about finding Teresa Halbach's car key on the seventh search of Avery's bedroom.
I informed the other two officers that there's a key laying on the floor and it was not there before. They all looked at it. At that point, Deputy Kucharski photographed it and subsequently collected it.
Lieutenant Link, let me just ask you, were you surprised to see that key?
Yes, sir, I was.
Why?
It wasn't there before.
After the collection of the key, did you, Deputy Kucharski, and Sergeant Colburn attempt to ascertain where the key had come from or do some further investigation?
Yes, we did.
Tell the jury what kind of investigation you did, please.
We looked at the cabinet. At the back corner of the cabinet, we saw that there was an opening between the back of the cabinet and the side, approximately a half to an inch. And we believed that that's where the key had fallen from the cabinet.
Do you suppose that if a defense lawyer stood up and asked you, did you plant blood in Teresa Halbach's car, do you suppose you'd tell me?
Yes, sir.
You think
I
you
did
would?
Not.
All right, who do you think won here? We have the two main players, the two cops who allegedly planted the evidence.
Well, I think it depends what you're looking at. You've got a couple issues. Ken Kratz is going to try to strike this theory of defense instruction, mm-hmm. but that's way too premature. Then, really, one thing that stands out is this car key. I don't think we've heard an adequate explanation how it's on the sixth or seventh search. They come in, there's a picture of this key on the ground next to these slippers, and no one saw that at any time mm-hmm. earlier. And the only explanation we have so far is that there was a cabinet nearby and they think it fell out of the cabinet. Why didn't someone hear it or see it fall when they were moving the cabinet or searching the cabinet? And why haven't we seen the actual cabinet as to how this even could have happened? So what strikes me is that it seems to be very bizarre how that key just sort of magically appeared.
Most murder trials are fairly bizarre, though, aren't they?
Well, that's true. You never know what's going to come up at a trial. That's true.
All right. Thanks, Rob. Hey, we'll have...